Hi students, welcome back to the Google Classroom. Class 7 History Chapter 4 The Mughal Empire. How are you children? Okay, I hope all of you are fine and safe there at home. So children, in the last class we have learned about Akbar. Okay, then who wrote Akbarnama? Abul Fasl. Then who were known as Mansabdars? Those who joined in Mughal service were known as Mansabdars. Okay, then today we will study about other three emperors. Which are they? Jahangir, Shah Jahan, and the last one, Aurangzeb.
Nuruddin Muhammad Salim, known by his imperial name Jahangir, was born on 30th August 1569, was the fourth Mughal emperor who ruled from 1605 until his death in 1627. Jahangir was the eldest surviving son of Mughal Emperor Akbar and was declared successor to his father from an early age. Jahangir was married to Shah Begum, a princess from Amber, who killed herself in 1605 out of shame at the rebellion of her son Prince Khusru. So Jahangir was the fourth Mughal emperor after Akbar. Okay. Military campaign started by Akbar continued. The Sisodia ruler of Mewar, Amar Singh, accepted Mughal service during Jahangir's reign. Less successful campaigns against the Sikhs, the Ahams and the Ahmednagar followed during the reign of Jahangir. Mehrunisa or Nur Jahan occupies an important place in the history of Jahangir. She was the widow of a rebel officer Sher Afghan of Mughals. She was beautiful and strong woman. She soon became Jahangir's favorite queen and assumed the title of Nur Jahan, that means light of the world. Nur Jahan herself came to exercise considerable influence over her husband, and Jahangir is said to have relied heavily on her advice. This is the picture of Nur Jahan. Shahabuddin Muhammad Shah Jahan was born on 5th January 1594. He was the fifth Mughal emperor of India. He is also known as Shah Jahan I. Shah Jahan assumed the Mughal throne on 24th January 1628 in Agra, a few days after the death of Jahangir. Shah Jahan has left behind an extraordinary architectural legacy. It was at his command that the Taj Mahal was built in Agra in memory of his favorite wife Mumtaz Mahal. So children, Shah Jahan's period or reign from 1627 to 1658. Mughal campaigns continued in the Deccan under Shah Jahan. The Afghan noble Khan Jahan Lodi rebelled and was defeated during the reign of Shah Jahan. Children, look at this picture. This is Taj Mahal. Aurangzeb eventually triumphed in the succession struggle by methodically eliminating his brothers. Aurangzeb captured Shah Jahan on 8th June 1658 and had him jailed at the Agra fort, from where the old emperor could look wistfully at the glorious Taj. Shah Jahan died in captivity on 22nd January 1666 at the age of 72. And the second one is the tomb of Mumtaz Mahal and Shah Jahan. Aurangzeb, Emperor Shah Jahan's sixth son, was born on 24th October 1618 at Dohad, in Madhya Pradesh and wrested India's crown from his father before the end of June 1658 after defeating his brother Prince Dara Shikoh's armies. Dara Shikoh, the eldest son of Shah Jahan, was resident at Shah Jahan's court as the designated heir. Shuja was governor of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. Aurangzeb governed the Deccan and Murad was the governor of Gujarat and Malwa. Aurangzeb took his own father prisoner. Shuja's army was routed in battle and Murad was lured into a false agreement and taken prisoner. Dara eventually collected together another force, suffered defeat as before, and once again he fled. But soon he was betrayed by one of his allies and handed over to his brother. So children, Aurangzeb's reign was from 1658 to 1607. During the reign of Aurangzeb, Ahams were defeated in 1663 and rebelled against in 1680s. Rathore Rajputs rebelled against Mughal intervention during the period of Aurangzeb. Campaigns against Maratha Shivaji was initially successful. Prince Akbar rebelled against Aurangzeb and received support from Marathas and Deccan Sultanates. Aurangzeb fled to Safavid Iran. Aurangzeb sent armies again and annexed Bijapur in 1685 and Golconda in 1687. He also forced rebellion in the North India from Sikhs, Jats and Satnamis, in the Deccan from Marathas and from Ahams. His death was followed by a succession conflict among his sons. So children, it's time to wind up our session. Shall I ask some questions? Okay. Who was the fourth emperor of Mughal? Yes, Jahangir. And who built Taj Mahal? Shah Jahan. Okay, so please note that the corresponding URL, notes of the lesson and test paper are also attached along with this video. Make use of all these available resources. Study well and attend the test paper without fail. Thank you.